Hey everybody, hope you're doing well. This is Andy from the Loaded Grape, coming to you with a really fantastic wine. We don't talk a lot about Riesling, but it should be talked about. Every time you mention the word, people are kind of afraid of it. I don't know why, but they do have a reputation for being sweet. We've only featured one Riesling, I think, in our wine club over the past 2 years, and because there's one reason. We want to find a bone dry Riesling or a dry Riesling, something that represents the area well, and we did that with that one. And I think we found another one. This time, we're coming to you from America, though. So this is from New York, Seneca Lake, New York. This is a great representation of what a Riesling should taste like from New York. So Riesling grape, just in general, originally from Germany, way back 1400s. Some people say early as 1300s from Austria, are very floral, very aromatic. Rieslings can age over 100 years. A well-done Riesling can especially do that. It is one of the best wines up there. I mean, it ranks up there. It's one of my top three whites for sure. You know, when you look at great wines to drink and what you can have, Rieslings are definitely up there. A lot of people, you know, admit them or just skip them because they think they're sweet, and they're so missing out. They're great with food, especially spicy foods. You know, grab your sriracha sauce, get your takeout food, and add some sriracha sauce on it, no matter what it is, and, you know, have a glass of Riesling with it. It'll cut through that fire, to cut through that spice, even a dry Riesling, because even a dry Riesling has a teeny bit of usually residual sugar. I think this one has like 0.3, it's one of the great wines you can drink and have, and you can age these. You know, a decent Riesling, you know, from America, you know, just an ordinary Riesling, you could definitely age it for 15 years. I don't know why you would do that, you know, unless you just really, really like it and want to keep it and see how it changes from year to year, which I would definitely recommend you can do that if you find one you really enjoy. But I always tell people, if you're going to get Riesling, go to Mosel, go to Germany. That's where you buy it from, all right? But if you can't go to Germany or you want to try something else, go to New York. Brought over, you know, when immigrants came over, German immigrants came over in America, they brought their vines with them. And they planted Riesling in New York, and it's thrived. It's perfect. They enjoy cool climate. And, you know, obviously New York has that. And they have done a really good job. Now, this one is from Forge Cellars out of New York. So East, there's the label right there. East Seneca Lake. Right there. Now this is a dry Riesling, and it says it on the label. Like I said, it has 0.3 residual sugar, which that means they've added just a tiny bit of sugar, which is a normal. So they do that in a lot of wines, not just Rieslings. But this is a bone dry Rieslings, and we're gonna taste it and figure a little bit about it and try it. Like I said, we've only had one in our wine club. I would put this in our wine club, I think, that much of this wine. And, you know, this is a white wine, and you say, hey, you got a really big bowl there. I do. You know why? Because as in Burgundy or Pinots, you want a big bowl so you can stick your nose in it, because they're very aromatic. 80% of what you taste is what you smell, give or take. So get you a big bowl, pour it in there, and get you a big whiff. All right, there's the color right there. Great Rieslings are known to have little petrol notes, little dirty socks going on. It obviously don't taste like that, but that's when you know you got a really good quality Riesling. And this is no exception. You know, I get a little bit of jasmine, licorice notes out of that, a little bit of apricot, which is they're really well known for, to be known for their aromatics and flavor profile. Great classic example of Riesling. This is a New York Riesling. It's got a lot of acidity. Rieslings are known to be very floral and have a lot of acidity. This one is no exception. And you know that it has a lot of acidity because as soon as you taste the wine and you drink it, your mouth starts to salivate and you get a lot of salivation going on back here in the sides of your throat or the sides of your mouth. And this is what's happening. And that's also the reason why it can age well. And it's also a reason why it can go well with food. if you want to try something new, you're not used to it, you're tired of your Chardonnay, you're tired of your Sauvignon Blanc, Pinot Grigio, try a bone dry Riesling. You'll be very happy that you did. This is, you know, a great example of it. And I would, you know, start this off with aperitif. I would have it with spicy foods. I would give it as a gift. That's how well I think of this wine. It's very good. You should try it. It's summer. It's going to be very good with hot weather and great foods, barbecue foods. If you like spicy foods, you know, try this on it and try a little something different, you know, break it up a little bit. Thanks for watching. Cheers.